Hoy en Kobe Pro Wrestling nos visita la legendaria Mickie James. D-Line defiende los títulos de pareja en contra de Good Vibes. Y en nuestra pelea estelar, Jessie Bell reta a Amber Rodríguez por el título de mujeres. Kobe Pro Wrestling arranca ya mismo. Hola, sean todos bienvenidos a una edición más de Kobe Pro Wrestling. Y hoy en nuestra pelea estelar, la princesa boricua Amber Rodríguez ha sido retada por Jessie Bell. También hoy D-Line defenderá los títulos de pareja en contra de Good Vibes. Pero primero vamos al ring con Dashing Donny Diablo, que tiene una entrevista exclusiva con Mickie James.
Get this straight, I am the voice of reason in Kobe Pro. And you know what? Although none of you in here deserve what I'm about to give you, I'm gonna do it anyway. Why? Because I'm better than everybody clearly in here. And you know, we said we would show you Mickie James, so why don't we just bring Mickie James out? Why don't we bring Mickie James out so all you West Virginia inbred hillbilly morons get something that you want out of tonight? How about it? Hardcore Country! Alright folks, like I said, this is far more than you deserve, but I'm gonna ask some questions here to Mickie James. First off, Mickie, you've been gone for a couple years. What have you been doing in the meantime?
Gone where? I've been gone where for a couple years? I've been here, I've been there, I've been everywhere. Just like Johnny Cash. I've been working on my music, I've been wrestling, I've been being me, and wrestling. A little bit of everything. What have you been doing? Besides wearing some really awesome gloves.
Yeah, these are awesome gloves, aren't they? You know, there's a rumor going around, and I just want to see if we can confirm this or not, that you're pregnant.
It's my personal life, but sure, yes, I'm pregnant. Thank you.
So, first child. Alright, first child. So there's gonna be another change in the world. Alright, well, I don't know, what's next for Mickie James? Where are you going next? What do you want to do next?
I don't really know. Like, this obviously has taken me on a whole nother course. A little unexpected, but a very wonderful and beautiful course in my life, and so I'm really excited about it. So who's to say what's next? Except for a lot of that. And, you know, some baby rocking, cradle pushing, stuff like that.
So we're going to see Mickie James back on the ring anytime soon?
I don't know.
You are? Yeah, because I don't know. I mean, I don't know either, especially after having the baby. I don't really think you're going to make a Divas calendar again, do you?
Sophisticated, I just make it look easy. Follow. I'm so sophisticated. To get a person, we gotta be initiated. To get a person, we should gotta be sophisticated.
Oh, look. It's Mickie James, the washed up ex diva. I'm sorry, I'm surrounded by idiots. Once again, Mickie James, the washed up ex diva. Oh, and look, you're bringing in a child to this world. Like, you really wouldn't need. But out of the kindness of my heart, I baked you a little pie because I know you like to eat for two, right? I mean, since I couldn't get you what I really wanted, which was a coat hanger for an abortion. So why don't you take this? Right, I know you're hungry. Come on, don't be scared.
Parece que Jesse Bell no puede contenerse las ganas de pelear con Amber Rodriguez. Y bueno, solamente en un par de minutos hoy nuestra pelea estelar tendrá la oportunidad cuando se enfrente a la princesa boricua por el título de mujeres de Kobe Pro Wrestling. Es tiempo de una pequeña pausa, pero al regresar, D-Line defenderá los títulos de pareja en contra de Good Vibes. Hola, soy Juan Antonio Acevedo y esto es Kobe Pro Wrestling. Disfruta de la acción inigualable de la lucha libre sábados de mediodía a la una de la tarde, solo por LA TV.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hola, amigos. Soy Adriana. Y si tú eres un empresario, este mensaje es para ti. Kobe Pro Wrestling está cambiando la cara del entretenimiento. Cada semana le traemos no solo la mejor acción dentro del ring, sino también cobertura sobre todos los eventos más relevantes en el área y entrevistas exclusivas que no verán en ningún otro show. Los invito a que formen parte de la revolución del entretenimiento y promocionen sus productos con nosotros. Llámenme para platicar de nuestros paquetes introductorios. La información está en pantalla. La revolución del entretenimiento ya empezó. No te quedes afuera.
Hola de nuevo. Están viendo Kobe Pro Wrestling por LA TV. Y si apenas va sintonizándonos, déjenme que le cuente que al principio del show, Dashing Donnie Diablo tenía una entrevista exclusiva con Mickie James que fue rápidamente arruinada cuando la princesa boricua Amber Rodriguez llegó. Veamos qué fue lo que pasó.
Right, I know you're hungry. Come on, don't be scared. You're welcome.
Really?
Yeah.
think I won't. Don't think I won't. Do not think that I won't. You know what? This is your girl, right? This is your girl, right?
Y recuerden que hoy en nuestra pelea estelar, Jessie Bell tiene la oportunidad de pelear contra Amber Rodriguez por el título de mujeres de Kobe Pro Wrestling. Pero ahora es tiempo de que D-Line defienda el título de parejas en contra de Good Vibes.
The tag team title can change hands via count out or disqualification.
New champ tonight.
Introducing first. The challengers.
Yeah. don't trust them.
Why would anybody trust the D-line after what they've done?
I wasn't talking about D-line. I'm talking about good vibes. Who wants to shake their hands?
Seriously?
I'm dead serious.
This is going to be a very interesting match because this is actually going to be the first time we have a real win-lose situation between good vibes and the D-line.
What do you mean a real win-lose situation? D-line beat them last time.
The only reason D-line still won that match was because of a belt shot to the back of Chrissy Rain's head.
I don't know. I think Chrissy is suffering from narcolepsy at times and just fell asleep before the powerbomb. That's the way I see it. You say a head shot to the back of the head with the belt.
And for that matter, the way they won the belts to begin with was 1-1-2. This time, we have an even playing field across the board.
It's never going to be an even playing field when you've got the greatest tag team in professional wrestling today standing across from you.
They don't have the ability to duck out by a DQ or a countout. They have to earn the win tonight if they get it.
Well, and they're going to earn the win tonight, Chris. They're the best tag team in Cubby Pro. No, the best tag team in the world.
For right now, those belts do say that. Those belts they hold prove they are the best, but they got to prove it to everybody else tonight against good vibes. Lock up into a rear waist lock, one tremendous, Trevor. Black Ice has got a good grip.
And you hear Black Ice, he's saying he ain't going anywhere.
Reversal from Trevor, sunk it in deep.
Oh, look at the power.
Sheer muscle lock into a big elbow to the jaw on tremendous Trevor. Black Ice off the rope, into a drop toe hold. Trevor up.
Misses.
Went for the basement drop kick, but missed it. Black Ice didn't miss that shoulder block, though.
He ate all of it, and that is why they're your tag team champions.
I take nothing.
How about showing some respect to your tag team champions, Berkeley Springs?
I take nothing away from the D-line. They're tremendous. But are they really as good as they think they are? Or are they just scared of good vibes?
I think they're better than they even say they are. So that speaks volumes right there.
Black Ice works Trevor back into the corner. We gonna get a clean break? Nope. But Trevor takes over with right hands in the corner on Black Ice.
Maybe those advanced thugonomics tapes came in.
Spearfish Irish Whip, reversal from Black Ice. But he eats a back elbow from Trevor. And a diving hooking clothesline.
Timeout. They called a timeout. Black Ice said timeout.
There's no timeouts in wrestling.
Well, they're the D-line. They can call a timeout. There's three on the board, right?
Basement dropkick from Trevor sends down both members of the D-line.
They just cleared out the front row as well. Somebody, there's some water spilled, popcorn. Now fans are moving out of the way now.
It looks like take a wrestler home tonight here at Cubby Pro.
There's been more action outside the ring than there is in there. We should have just left it at home. Oh my, do you hear Pat Lawson?
Hall of Famer Pat Lawson laying down the law to Black Ice.
How disrespectful can you be? That's the tag team champions you're talking to.
And that's the Hall of Fame referee putting him in his place. Big knee lift from Black Ice, followed up by the right hand. Make it two and Trevor goes down.
Taking a bow.
Taking a little too much time, in my opinion.
He's taking a bow for all these inbred hillbillies here in West Virginia.
Trevor firing back with rights and lefts and a kick, but overhead German suplex with a release. No bridge all impact into the pin, fails to hook the leg, and Trevor slides out the back. Now Black Ice reining in right hands.
Hola, soy Juan Antonio Acevedo y esto es Cubby Pro Wrestling. disfruta de la acción inigualable de la lucha libre sábados de mediodía a la una de la tarde, solo por LA TV.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hola, amigos. Soy Adriana. Y si tú eres un empresario, este mensaje es para ti. Covey Pro Wrestling está cambiando la cara del entretenimiento. Cada semana le traemos no solo la mejor acción dentro del ring, sino también cobertura sobre todos los eventos más relevantes en el área y entrevistas exclusivas que no verán en ningún otro show. Los invito a que formen parte de la revolución del entretenimiento y promocionen sus productos con nosotros. Llámenme para platicar de nuestros paquetes introductorios. La información está en pantalla. La revolución del entretenimiento ya empezó. No te quedes afuera.
The black guy is going to have to be careful with reining in the right hands. He could get disqualified off of that.
He could, but I don't know. You know, Pat seems to be in a different state of mind. I've never seen Pat quite snap like that. Whoa.
Beautiful double team from the D-line. I think Pat's being a touch lenient tonight, actually.
I don't know. I'm not sure about the lenient part of that, but that side slam and leg drop combo is just vicious, and I don't think Trevor's gonna... See?
Only two, save from Chris.
How about a DQ there? If you're gonna call it one way, call it one way.
Pat's talking to Chrissy right now while...
That's not half the talking he gave to D-Line.
Body snatcher puts Trevor back in the corners. Starts raining in the right hands again. And a big slap to the face.
Oh!
Those sting so bad.
You can feel the bass off that all the way over here. And again.
That'll bring the blood to the surface and Trevor goes down. Oh. Understandably so.
He's gonna have a big handprint tattoo for a couple weeks.
They could take a DNA sample off that man's chest right now. But Trevor fires back with a standing drop kick.
That was desperation. And a desperation tag into Big Chrissy.
It paid off, but the body snatcher barrels to the outside. Smart move.
Very smart move.
Slow the momentum. They got a 10 count on the outside to play with. Body snatcher breaking the count. Smart move on his part. Take as much time as you can on the outside. Get your rest.
And take a little bit of a breather before getting back in there with Chrissy Reyes. Chrissy's fresh. I mean, he's not really seen any action in there yet. You see Trevor's clenching those ribs, and you can already see the welts coming up on its back. I don't even want to know what the chest looks like right now.
There's a little bit of a receipt to the body snatcher from Chrissy Reyes firing in them elbow, that first overhand knife and chop, and then shoulder blocks into the midsection. Here comes the Irish Whip out of the corner. Chrissy eats nothing but turnbuckles.
Chrissy was coming in fast and hard, and he burned on that one.
Big Yakuza kick from the body snatcher.
And the taunting from Black Ice to ask Chrissy if it hurts.
A little insult to injury.
Oh, wow.
Speaking of injury, into the pin, hooks the leg.
I think Pat was a little slow on that count.
Only two. Then comes Black Ice.
Shut up, Charlie Brown. No one wants to hear you. I don't care if you're a Hall of Famer or not, I will go out there and slap the taste out of your mouth.
Delayed double vertical suplex from the D-line, beautifully done.
That's it. Wrapped him up. And again with the interference.
Smart move by Trevor to make the save. All that blood had rushed to Chrissy's head. It was unlikely he would have kicked out of that.
Well, D-line makes the tag.
And both of them raining in the shots on Chrissy. Trevor's not doing his partner any favors right now.
And pandemonium's broken out now. I mean, are you going to get control of this match back, Pat? What do you...
Trevor fired to the outside, getting beaten down by Black Ice. Meanwhile, the body snatchers in the ring all alone with Chrissy Reigns.
They're coming over here.
But the body snatcher's distracted. He's not paying attention. Chrissy said...
On the floor. Oh!
Vertical suplex on the floor, but look at Chrissy in the ring.
Oh, no.
Big power bomb.
No, he might... No! No!
It only takes 3 seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Wait a minute, who was the legal man? Was he even the legal man?
Honestly, I couldn't tell you who was the legal man in this situation. It only takes 3 seconds of distraction. Black Ice was distracted just long enough. Black Ice out here fighting with Trevor distracted him just long enough. He could not make the save.
I don't know. I'm like you. I'm not sure if this is even yes, he got the three count, but was he the legal man?
I honestly do not know, but at this point in time, it doesn't make a bit of difference. You're winners and new tag team champions. Good vibes.
Felicidades a Good Vibes, que logró lo imposible y ha vencido a D-Line, convirtiéndose en los nuevos campeones de pareja en Kobe Pro Wrestling. Y hablando de imposibles, veamos qué fue lo que pasó la semana pasada.
I mean, you've got the Persian Immortal itself. Meanwhile, Wild off the ropes.
Great save with that double axe handle. And Wild's firing up.
Shades of the Ultimate Warrior.
This match is in memorial of the Warrior, and he certainly seems to be channeling that spirit.
Trading chops over on CEO.
Big rights and lefts back and forth between Count Lestat and Brown Sugar Jones on the outside. And Nyla Rose gets booted down by Napalm Bomb. Chris Wall's heading back up the ladder again.
Oh, he just took the ladder right in the ribs.
Smart maneuver from Napalm Bomb. If you can cut that man out, cut his win, cut him out of the ring, get yourself alone. That's the best way to win in a ladder match.
You're right, Chris, and I don't think he's going to be able to climb that ladder anymore. I think, seriously, with a shot like that, those ribs have to be broken. But look out here. We've got CEO holding Brown Sugar, while Brown Sugar just got worked over by Nyla Rose. They missed the high five. She doesn't miss the hard right.
Huge power bomb from Napalm Bomb in the ring while Nyla's giving it to CEO on the outside.
I'm ready to
Napalm Bomb's doing the smart thing. Try to get everybody out of the ring.
He's biting. He's biting her across the face.
Mustafa Aziz biting Nyla Rose across the face. Meanwhile, Chris Wilder's made his way back into the ring with Napalm Bomb. And there's a brawl right here in front of us.
Now, CEO, it's hard to keep up with Chris. I mean, we've got Chris Wilder and Napalm Bomb tearing it up in the ring. Everybody else has spilled out to the outside. Richie, I mean, all I can do is just watch at this point.
But Chris Wilder pulled the low bridge on Napalm Bomb. Smart move. Get him out of the way.
Yeah, but with the rib shot he took, like you said, that's gonna affect the way he breathes. How's he gonna get up the ladder?
He's alone. This is his best chance.
There's still plenty of bodies on the outside.
That's the key word. They're on the outside. You have to be alone to get to that briefcase. It's your only way to win.
Well, it has taken far too much time. I don't think that's gonna happen.
I don't think Chris is going for the briefcase. I think Chris is gonna fly.
Oh, no. Oh!
Up the ladder and over the top to the floor on everybody. I don't think Chris got all that he wanted to, but he got certainly enough to take down most everybody in this match.
Like bowling pins, they're all pretty much down. I think only Brown Sugar and CEO escaped unharmed.
And Brown Sugar Jones just ate the other ladder. Amazingly, Chris is back into the ring.
And we still have bodies down. Napalm Bomb is still down and Countless Dots slowly getting up.
Napalm Bomb's holding that right shoulder.
The immortal himself, the Prince of Pain, Mustafa Aziz, now inside the ring and he's, oh no, here we go. Oh Lord, what?
Huge power bomb from Mustafa Aziz.
And Mustafa, he's repositioning the ladder. He may be going for it. No, no, he's not. He doesn't even care about the briefcase. Oh! You want to talk about damage to the ribs. Right back to those ribs of Chris Wilde.
Sit out smash from Mustafa Aiz. Meanwhile.
Now he's eyeing it.
Meanwhile, Gavin Jackson did a tope suicida off the apron onto everybody.
And he just ended up eating that ring post. Napalm Bomb's taking something. He's choking the life out of Gavin right now. Meanwhile, look, there's Mustafa's.
Mustafa's making his way up the ladder. He doesn't have anything interfering with him at the moment.
Well, spoke too soon.
He's got two men interfering with him now.
Well, Brown Sugar Jones and Countless Dot, we've seen them work together and against each other. They'll work together to get the upper hand and then turn the minute they do.
There's no friends in this situation.
You said that right.
Momentary allies at best. We saw that earlier with CEO and Nyla Rose.
Well, CEO now working over young Gavin Jackson, and there was a rake of the eyes. Meanwhile, back in the ring, implant DDT.
Beautifully done by Countless Dot.
Lestat's eyeing the briefcase. Oh, low blow. Nyla's got him up.
Big Samoan drop from Nyla Rose.
And a big elbow drop off the apron onto the floor by Gavin Jackson. Almost ended up right in the fan's lap. Pandemonium. Wow.
Mustafa Sahin. Aziz with that beautiful hooking clothesline of his. We've seen it before. He gets a lot of impact out of that right hand.
And especially when he hits it on Gavin Jackson. It's an honor. Oh!
Hip toss onto the ladder in the corner.
Now the Prince of Pain is rolling. He is using that ladder against everybody.
Make it two on CEO.
He just slapped the taste right out of Count's mouth.
I think we might have seen a thing go flying. We certainly just saw a body go flying into that ladder a third time in a row.
Well, two men are standing now, and that's Mustafa. Well, now three, but the only reason Gavin's standing is
they've been holding him up.
You're right.
Oh, this is not good.
Tandem.
Slim shot face first into the ladder on Gavin Jackson.
And it seems like Mustafa and Napalm Bomb are trying to work together, and he's Irish whip and a big knee.
Well, Nyla Rose, all impact. Remember what I said about temporary allies?
Temporary allies is right. You gotta look. And again, oh, did you see her head snap?
If it wasn't the impact to the front of the face, it was the impact to the back of her head from that turnbuckle.
You're right. The back of her head came. Wow.
If Nyla's not out, she's got to be close.
That may be a concussion right there. The back of her head just whipped off the turnbuckle.
Meanwhile, Gavin Jackson fighting with Brown Sugar Jones on the outside.
But look here. There seems to be a...
Dyson
trouble brewing in the ring. You said it before, temporary alliances.
Nyla Rose is up.
Takes them both out. Count going high risk.
The native beast just dropped Napalm Bomb and Mustafa Aziz.
Is the count gonna fly? Count goes for a frog splash. I don't think he got all of it.
Nyla's up.
She's up and she's got a ladder. Swanton!
Swanton Bob went to the side of the ribs!
Wow! Who would have thought, Chris? We can't even keep up with what's going on out there.
No CEO screaming in Nyla's face, but everybody else is down and out.
And another low blow from Nyla Rose.
CEO's gonna be singing soprano for the rest of the night.
Any plans he had for later on in the night are ruined. Nyla Rose trying to scale the ladder now.
The only one standing aside of her is Brown Sugar Jones.
She's just kicking Brown Sugar away. She's trying to, oh. I think she just caught her chin on the bottom rung of that ladder.
Brown Sugar Jones just swept the legs out from the front of Nyla and down she went. Brown Sugar's heading up, but Napalm Bomb and Mustafa Aziz are both up.
What a flying forearm.
And the ladder falls all the way down back onto Nyla Rose.
Nyla buried under the ladder. Chris Wilde, I don't even know what happened to him. He's laid out over in the far corner, and countless stocks over in front of that wacko with the hat.
Chris has been through a lot already this evening.
Chris already had to fight this evening just to get to this point.
He's definitely earned his place in this match.
Well, you...
Big Yakuza kick from Napalm Bomb on Mustafa.
You know what? If you're the other competitors, this is what you want to see. The two biggest bulls of the woods going at it right now. You want to see Napalm Bomb and Mustafa Aziz. What?
Super kick to the jaw of Mustafa Aziz. And he went down hard. And eats the Yakuza kick as well.
He didn't go all the way down until that Yakuza kick. He had Persian. The Persians, of course, known for their immortal warriors.
Well, if you're quoting the movie, you'd have to say at this point, this is Sparta.
This is indeed Sparta. And that kick from Napalm Bomb just sent Mustafa Aziz into the pit. Now look, they're both going up. Napalm Bomb's going up.
If this match wasn't dangerous enough, we've got two ladders set up and two big men climbing them.
I don't like the looks of this at all.
Napalm had his fingers on the
back. Oh!
Cutter from the top!
Oh my God, he broke him in half.
Humongous cutter from Chris Wilde off the top of the ladder.
There is no way any man.
And with the damage that man's taking, look at him firing up.
I'm still in shock, Chris. There's no way any man could get up from that. And there's carnage all around the ring. There may be nobody left to stop him.
He's all alone.
Nyla's trying to get in there, as is Aziz.
Too little, too late.
Ladies and gentlemen.
He got it. I can't believe it. Defying the odds.
After the damage that man took in his introductory match to Kobe Pro, and he made it through this ladder match and won it with that beautiful cutter off the top of the ladder. Oh my God. Have you seen anybody give a cutter like that off a ladder?
Absolutely not. That's something you're only going to see right here on Covey Pro. An insane cutter off the ladder. And napalm bomb, everyone took so much damage in this match, Chris.
But one thing has to be said about Chris Wilde tonight.
Chris Wilde no solamente venció a Shane Andrews para conseguir un contrato de Covey Pro Wrestling, sino que también entró a la pelea Ultimate Warrior contra Coalition, donde terminó ganando. Hablamos con él después del show y esto fue lo que nos dijo.
My whole life's been all or nothing. I knew coming in that I had to give the performance of a lifetime. I knew coming in order to get a chance to honor a legend, I had to go through one of the best talents in America in Shane Andrews, and I did just that. As you saw, I climbed the ladder last week and retrieved this. The Ultimate Warrior Contract Collision Ladder Match Briefcase, which gives me the power to challenge for that world title whenever I feel right to. Words can't express how much this briefcase means to me. It's absolutely one of the biggest accomplishments of my career, and I take it to heart. Just holding the briefcase itself, I can feel the power coming off of it. I can feel Covey Pro, I can feel the Warrior. And trust me, you ain't seen nothing yet. I think my actions speak louder than my words. Last week at All or Nothing, I proved that even the biggest dreams can come true. And trust me, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Es hora de una pequeña pausa, pero nuestra pelea estelar viene a continuación. Hola, soy Juan Antonio Acevedo y esto es Covey Pro Wrestling. Disfruta de la acción inigualable de la lucha libre, sábados de mediodía a la 1 de la tarde, solo por LA TV.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earthdog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hola, amigos. Soy Adriana. Y si tú eres un empresario, este mensaje es para ti. Covey Pro Wrestling está cambiando la cara del entretenimiento. Cada semana le traemos no solo la mejor acción dentro del ring, sino también cobertura sobre todos los eventos más relevantes en el área y entrevistas exclusivas que no verán en ningún otro show. Los invito a que formen parte de la revolución del entretenimiento y promocionen sus productos con nosotros. Llámenme para platicar de nuestros paquetes introductorios. La información está en pantalla. La revolución del entretenimiento ya empezó. No te quedes afuera.
Ahora sí, el momento ha llegado. Amber Rodríguez contra Jessie Bell por el título de mujeres.
Introducing first, the challenger. From Pikesville, Kentucky, she is a former Covey Pro Women's Champion. She is Jessie Bell McCoy!
Yeah. is the reigning Cubby Pro Women's Champion.
It's highly sophisticated. I just need you to easy. Follow me. I'm so sophisticated.
Amber
going into the lungs for one.
And it's a roll through into a pinning combination, but Amber was able to roll one through it. Good attempted counter from Amber, but here we go over again. Only one.
Now Amber flipping back for the pin attempt.
This is making Amber work even harder, and Jesse's giving her the tour of the ring.
Oh, so not only are you losing breath every time you take one in, as that vice squeezes in a little tighter, now you're dizzy from having rolled around the ring.
Think of a boa constrictor. And now think of a bronco.
Come on.
Oh. Swing out mom into a pin, hooks the leg. Only one.
The women's champ seems to be taking the brunt of the assault right now.
And the women's champion bails to the outside.
And that's a smart move.
After the offense, Jessie Bell put in order. She needs to catch her breath.
Jessie Bell giving her a chance to catch her breath, but here's the thing. She can't win the belt by a count out, so all Amber's got to do is keep walking around.
Yeah, but Amber better watch her back. Big right hand from Amber Rodriguez. Irish whip reverse. Make it two. And Jesse eats the corner post.
Right back in. You're right. She is the ultimate opportunist. the Barriqua Barbie, the Barbie Killer. She's got about 1,000 nicknames.
This works to Amber's advantage, as does that arm snap off the second rope. Jesse's well known for that Southern Comfort finish, and it takes both arms to apply it properly.
Well, and you don't think that our women's champ, being crafty and being from New York herself, is gonna realize that that's the way to go? Showing off a little for the crowd?
She may be showing off now, but we know she's done her homework for this match.
Hola, soy Juan Antonio Acevedo y esto es Kobe Pro Wrestling. Disfruta de la acción inigualable de la lucha libre sábados de mediodía a la 1 de la tarde, solo por LA TV.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earthdog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hola, amigos. Soy Adriana. Y si tú eres un empresario, este mensaje es para ti. Kobe Pro Wrestling está cambiando la cara del entretenimiento. Cada semana le traemos no solo la mejor acción dentro del ring, sino también cobertura sobre todos los eventos más relevantes en el área y entrevistas exclusivas que no verán en ningún otro show. Los invito a que formen parte de la revolución del entretenimiento y promocionen sus productos con nosotros. Llámenme para platicar de nuestros paquetes introductorios. La información está en pantalla. La revolución del entretenimiento ya empezó. No te quedes afuera.
I think they enjoyed that show.
Now right back here with the boost in the midsection. Right back to work on that left arm. Hammerlock with the knee driven into the shoulder blades. Make it two. And there's a third. Really focusing on the elbow joint and shoulder.
Yeah, she's, like you said, you know, Southern discomfort. If she's not able to, you know, a variation of a gory bomb, if she's not able to get that locked in without the use of both arms.
We've seen this before.
We have indeed. It's time for a little bump and grind.
Right into the scissor stomp.
There's nothing wrong with a little bump and grind.
I think Jesse would disagree with you at the moment.
Probably so, but nevertheless, to the hook of the leg.
Only two, not enough yet. But Jesse's left arm is obviously injured, right back into that hammerlock.
As our champ continues to work over the arm.
Focusing her attack on that elbow and shoulder. And there's a knee drop to the elbow, as we said. Make it two. And now they're punching away at the elbow.
Now you can almost see the swelling starting right now. She's done serious damage to that arm.
Amber had an arm bar applied, but Jesse fights up. I spoke too soon. Hair takedown from Amber Rodriguez.
What hair takedown? That was a snapback.
Amber going right back to work on that arm.
And see, Jesse tried to reach through to prevent that from happening.
Amber having that arm torqued around her own leg, and she's able to drive her knee into the shoulder while working on the elbow. Into a quick pin, both legs up. Only two.
You know, the old cliche about living to fight another day.
Double clothesline from Amber and Jesse. Living to fight another day may apply in some situations, but Jessie Bell, the Southern Spitfire, she doesn't give up that quick or that easily.
But the damage that has been done to the arm, that arm has been worked over, and she's still got to be out there on the road. She's still got to make a living.
Laying that boot to the midsection, cuts off, fires back with a shot to the jaw. Amber misses and takes a chop to the face. And a big neck takedown. Snapmare takeover. With a drive-by kick to the jaw and a double leg drop. Only
just
two.
Just a two count. Jessie seems to be able to, until now, mount some offense.
Jessie broke both of the suplex. Snap suplex with a float over. She's still got her locked in tight. Make it two.
Oh, this could be Trace Amigos. Shades of Eddie Guerrero.
Third time the drunk. Float over into the pin, hooks the leg. Only two. What's that Amber's got on her hand?
Nothing.
Looks like brass nuts to me.
You bet you need glasses.
Schoolboy takedown. All of the weight up on their shoulders.
There you go. Still.
The winner. And still, Kali Pro, women's champion.
This is an example of when bad meets evil. The experience of Jessie Bell lost out to the opportunism of Amber Rodriguez.
What Amber wants, Amber gets. And she's gonna return back to New York with the women's title.
But for how long? How long can this streak go?
I never used these. I'm fixing to.
Sin duda que Jessie Bell fue un gran oponente, pero al final Amber Rodriguez se mantiene como campeona. Amigos, eso es todo de mi parte. Muchas gracias por ver Kobe Pro Wrestling. Que tengan todos un muy buen fin de semana.